Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer, and welcome to something I'm quite excited to start up. I bought it yesterday during... There's the whole Steam summer sale going on right now, and this was... A good amount... Had a good discount on it, so I bought it, and... Something I've wanted to buy for a while, but... Just haven't got around to it. And... I'm very excited to get started on this. I've once again plugged in my Xbox controller to play this game. Dark Souls 3. God, I'm so excited to get into this. I am so fucking excited to get into this game. I did start it up earlier just to check that my camera being in the corner there wouldn't be an issue with life bars or anything, so... Yeah. Other than that, I haven't done anything with this. I've never played it before. All I did was... I skipped over the intro cutscene and everything, so all of it is going to be brand new to me. I have seen someone play through this, but I've seen them... I saw them do it multiplayer, which means this very first section wasn't in it, because apparently you can't do multiplayer in this first section. So, new game. Let's go.
Yes, indeed. It is called Lothric. Where the transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge.
So excited.
In venturing north, the pilgrims discover the truth of the old words. The fire fades, and the lords go without thrones.
Apologize for being so loud here.
Aldrich, Saint of the Deep. Farron's undead legion, the Abyss Watchers. Lord of the profaned capital. Yon the giant.
Awesome. This is gonna be fucking awesome.
Only in truth, the lords will abandon their thrones. And the unkindled will rise. Nameless, accursed undead, unfit even to be Cinder. And so it is that Ash seeketh embers.
Okay, I am very sorry for that being so loud. I did not realize it was going to get that loud there. Name. Let's go with... Oh yeah, I gotta use the keyboard. Let's just go with JC. Real original. Gender male, age young, class. An obscure knight of poor renown who collapsed roaming the land. Sturdy owing to high vitality and stout armor. Mercenary. Mercenary and veteran of the battlefield. High dexterity allows masterful wielding of dual scimitars. Warrior. Descendant of northern warriors famed for their brawn. Utilizes high strength to wield a heavy battle axe. Herald. A former herald who journeyed to finish a quest undertaken. Wields a sturdy spear and employs a gentle restorative miracle. Thief. A common thief and pitiful deserter. Wields a dagger intended for backstabs alongside a military-issue bow. Assassin. An assassin who stalks their prey from the shadows. Favors sorceries in addition to thrusting swords. Sorcerer. A loner who left formal academia... Whatever the fuck. I never know how to pronounce that word. To pursue further research. Commands soul sorceries using high intelligence. Pyromancer, a pyromancer from a remote region who manipulates flame. Also an adept close combat warrior who wields a hand axe. Cleric, a traveling cleric who collapsed from exhaustion. Channels high faith to cast many and varied miracles. Or deprived, naked, and of unknown origin. Either an unfathomable fool in life or was stripped of possessions upon burial. I like the idea of the assassin using sorceries and swords, because that's typically what I like to go for in a game, is kind of an all-around magic and combat type of thing. Burial gift. No sign of a burial gift or otherwise. Life ring. Ring set with a small red jewel raises maximum HP. Divine blessing. Warm blessed holy water fully restores HP and cures ailments. Hidden blessing. Pure blessed holy water fully restores FP. Black firebomb. Firebomb charged with a special black powder. An uncouth gift for the departed. Uncouth, uncouth, whatever the fuck it is. Fire gem, material used to upgrade to fire weapons, more appropriate for a warrior than pretty trinkets. Sovereignless soul. The sovereignless soul of one who slept beside you, used to acquire many souls. Rusted gold coin, burial item for good fortune after death, greatly increases item discovery for a short while. Cracked red eye orb, online play item, one use only, become a dark spirit and invade another world, or young white branch. Branch of a young white birch, perhaps an offering of peace, can be used to blend into environment, but only once. I'll go with fire gem, that sounds like the most useful one. Face presets. Commoner, Northern Warrior, Stora Noble, Dragon Academy student, Karim Novice, Katarina Merrymaker, Serpentine Traveler, Great Swamp Outcast, Londor Shadow of Death, Irithilian. I kind of like the whole extremely pale. Build. Standard, slim, very slim. Burly, very burly. Burly upper body, burly lower body, small head, or large head. I think I'll go with very slim. Appearance. I think I'd rather have a young voice. Physique. Musculature, standard or muscular? Oh god, that is creepy. Why not? Body hair. Standard or thick? You know what? Fuck it. Why not? Build detail. Head. That is a big head. Can I make it a really super tiny head? I can. Let's go with a huge head. And everything else is going to be small. It's not gonna work, is it? Fine, let's go with a huge... Fine, whatever. Let's just make it really tiny. Everything's gonna be all scrawny. Zero for everything. No. Base skin color. Oh, jeez. Oh, it would be nice if I could actually see colors here other than just Oh Jesus. Oh wow, that is just disturbing. Okay, that's just creepy. That is creepy as all hell. I like it. Now I'll go with... How far up does this go? 255, I think. Yeah, 255, so... 125 will be half of 250. Let's just go with 125 on everything. That makes me what, gray? Let's go a little more red. What's 200 on everything look like? That skin tone, light skin color, blue or orange, yellow or purple. I'm just gonna make this look really weird. Green, pallid, red. Cheek color, red, laugh lines, dark. That just looks weird. Face detail, similar face. Oh, thank you. Features, parent age, very young. Facial aesthetic, masculine or feminine? Masculine, what's feminine look like? Oh god, that is just disturbing. So what was this? 255, of course. There isn't an actual, like, right in the middle. Oh dear God, what have I done? What have I done? Yes. Yes, please. Face shape, facial balance, nose size, narrow or wide. Oh dear God. Gotta go with wide. Nose forehead ratio. Forehead or nose? Gotta go for that nose. Face protrusion. Convex or concave? Oh dear God. What am I doing? You know what? I'm just gonna make everything all scrunched in. Vertical facial spacing. Facial feature slant. Just make it all scrunched in. Jesus Christ. That is horrifying. Yeah, why not? Slight. Nah, I'll go with deep. I'm just gonna try to make it as fucked up as I can. That's how I always do it. This is not gonna look good. No, I gotta do this. I gotta make the nose as pronounced as possible compared to the rest of the face. That nose has got to stick out more than anything else. Brow ridge. Brow ridge height. Oh dear God, what have I done? What have I created? I can't even tell what that's doing. Inner brow ridge. Low. Oh god. Outer brow ridge. High. I have way too much fun doing. Oh my god. I have way too much fun doing this stuff. Yeah, that works. Eyes. Eye position. Up. Down. Let's go within the middle, kind of. Right where it was, I guess. Eye size. Biggest fucking eyes I can get. That's not very big. I was hoping for, like, anime eyes. Like, just fucking huge. Oh, dear God. Yeah, why not? Yep. Nose ridge depth. Slight or deep? No, I want a deep. deep. Norse ridge length, long. Norse position, up,
nah,
down. Oh dear God. They gave me way too much to customize in this one. Norse tip height. I can't even tell what that's doing. Looks like it's just making the nose longer. Nose protrusion. Oh, gotta go with convex. Now, what's concave look like? Nope, gotta go with convex. Nose height. High or low? Why does the height make it smaller? That don't make any sense at all. Nose slant. Up or down? Up. Up makes it look bigger. Oh my god, this is creepy. Nostrils. Oh god. Nostril slant. Up or down? I think I like up better. Not down, it makes it look bigger. Nostril size, enormous. That's not an option, okay. Small or large? Gotta go with the small nostrils on the giant nose. Nostril width, wide, nah, narrow as fuck, man. Nasal size. I can't tell what that's doing. Oh. That is not doing much. There we go. Okay. Cheeks. Gotta make those as sunken as possible. Cheekbone height. Gotta sink those cheeks in as much as possible. Oh my god, what have I created? Oh well. Yeah, let's do that. Lips. I can barely even see my fucking mouth. Lip shape. Purse or... Oh my god. Oh my god, no. Oh my god, no. Mouth expression, you got... He's gonna be sad. If you looked like this, you'd be sad. Lip fullness. Ah, we gotta have the fullest fucking lips. Lip size, large. Oh my god, this is just disturbing. Lip protrusion, my lips gotta stick out. Nah, you know what, fine. Lips can sink in. Lip thickness, thick. Gotta have them thick lips. Nah, nothing. I like how the lips adjust the chin. Mouth. Oh boy. Mouth protrusion. Definitely gotta have it convex. Make this face nothing but nose. Mouth slant. Yeah, I gotta make this face nothing but nose. Wait, shit, I'm 24 minutes in and I've been building my character. Mouth position, up. Or down. I like up. mouth width. Narrow. Very narrow. Yeah, that actually. Oh god, that looks creepy. Yeah, we gotta go with narrow. Mouth chin distance. Long? Nah, short. Make that chin like the mouth itself. I don't know. Chin tip position. Front or back? Back. Gotta make, like I said, I gotta make it so that the whole face is the nose and nothing else. Chin length, short. Chin protrusion, small. Chin depth, slight. Oh my god, what did I just do? Chin size, large. Nah, small. Chin height, low. No, high. Chin width, narrow, of course. Oh my god. I'm gonna be the most feared fucking undead in the entire universe. Jaw protrusion. Small. Narrow. Lower jaw. No, lower jaw. I want high. And jaw contour. Hair and facial hair. Hair, brow, and beard. Gotta go with some wacky hair color. Nah. Screw it. Something that you just don't see people wear. Well, then again, you do see people with pretty much every color possible for their hair, so. Actually, you know what? Let's go with that. Hair. Okay, now I get to pick my hairstyle. No, I gotta have some kind of hair here. Can I go with something really crazy? No? Really? There's no, like, wild. Oh, that's getting into female styles, I think. Whatever. Doesn't really matter. Just whatever I think looks funny. I'll go with this one. Why not? Hair color. What? Didn't I already? Brow. None. Brow color. I don't have a brow. Beard. Oh, dear God. That must. Oh my god, that mustache. No, no beard. Eyelashes. None. Eyelash color. I don't have any, so it doesn't matter. Pupils. Now that we can see them. Color of pupils. Gotta go with something crazy here. Okay, we can't even see him. So whatever. Right pupil. Cosmetics. Tone around eyes. Dark. Or light. I don't fucking care. Light. Eyelid brightness. Let's go with light. Eyelid color, pale. Eyeliner, light. Eyeshadow, light. Oh my god. Lipstick. Powder or dark red? Oh god, oh man. Okay, yeah, I gotta go with the dark red there. Dark blue or bright red? Let's just make it as red as possible. So I've got just this really fucked up red mouth there. Tattoo or mark? Oh god, what the fuck? Now let's go with, no, let's go with none. Save to favorites, of course. And we gotta change the name, man. We gotta change the name. No, I'm not gonna do that. I could, but I'm not going to. I was thinking I could name him Adrian Brody. Oh, that would be horrible. That would just be rude. The beak. The beak, there we go. The most feared undead. Not really. Finalize creation. Let's do this. Let's get over there and kick some ass. Oh, wow. That took me way too long. That took way too fucking long. I had way too much fun with that thing. I always do the character creation. You always have... That's the thing with Dark Souls games. You have... And most of the games like that, where they give you customization like this one and... Many of your, what the hell's it called? Many of the, Elder Scrolls series. You take forever to customize your character and then you don't even see them for most of the game. They're covered in armor. Oh boy. What the fuck is spook? Regular attack, yep. Strong attack, yep. Target locker release. Ow. Damn. How was that a critical hit? Ow! Hey! What the fuck, man? Not cool. Not cool, man. X to use item. Y, two-hand right weapon. Whoa. That is cool. I like that. But what was over this way? What was back here? Something. Soul of a deserted corpse. How did I use that stuff again? Inventory. Use. Whatever. I'll figure it all out. It's been so long since I played one. Oh fuck, not that button. Damn it. Man, I done fucked up. To go actually. Awesome. I still got it. Somebody got killed by that. Oh, Jesus. That looked like they had several enemies hitting them. What is the Ashen Estus flask? Turn back. Why? And there's a blood stain here. Uh-oh. Well, when it says to turn back, you know I gotta come investigate it. Oh, what in the fuck are you? You look bad. You look really bad. Should I go fuck him up? More like, should I go get fucked up? Oh my god. Looks like I should have listened. Holy shit. Damn. Shit, these guys are all back now. Why did I come back here? It's not like they're gonna give me another item. There we go. I didn't do it right last time. Ah, that's what it was. Come on. I'm doing exactly what it says. Left stick plus right button is kick, or right bumper is kick. Or no, right bumper, whatever the fuck it is. Smaller one. And it does that. That is not a kick. I never could get the hang of kicking in these games. I don't know what it is. It's just, for whatever reason, I could never get the hang of kicking in these. Fuck. Man, I suck at this shit. Hey, is that? No, it's not. Nah. Of course it wouldn't be an item. This looks nice. Ah, we've got a shrine. Best to have bonfire, or bonfire, not shrine. What the fuck am I saying? Best to have bonfire, restore HP and Estus supply. Light bonfire. Bonfire lit. Best to have bonfire. Now that respawns enemies, if I remember correctly. Surprise there. Good thing I was being cautious. Oh boy. Oh, this looks dangerous. Over here. Ah. close. You assholes. This better be worth it. 5 firebombs, not really. Oh, and it looks like my shield has been damaged, and so has my sword. Was that a thing in the original game? In the first two? I think so, yeah. Or is it telling me to jump to, though? It's telling me how to jump, but where does it want me to jump to? Right there. Titanite shard. Nice. Ah! Suck on that, asshole. Why am I down here? I should have gone to the fucking bonfire. Because in there is my first boss fight. I know that for sure. I know this. Because I recognize that from what I have seen of this game. What exactly does spook even do? Mask noises of caster and prevent fall damage. So basically it makes me quiet. Okay. I am not ready for this. I am in no way ready for this. But then again, that's Dark Souls. Immediately throws you into a boss fight without giving you time to prepare. That's just how the series works. So let's check it out, shall we? I know I'm gonna die at least once on this fight. I know I am. If I don't, I got extremely lucky. Oh boy. About dodging, that is a very big part of this game. Damn it. I knew I was gonna die, though. Holy fuck. Are you kidding me? Holy shit. Fuck, man. I'm not prepared for this. Not what I meant to do. Damn it. I'm dead. Jesus Christ. How am I supposed to fight this guy? Wow. How in the fuck am I supposed to do this? Okay, maybe I can use these fire bombs. That helps a little bit, not taking that damage from him, but I don't know how much it'll help. This is gonna be a horrible game, isn't it? How how am I meant to do this? God damn, man. Now I've only got one firebomb left. Asshole. Is that all I can get from them is fading souls? Too much damage, so I gotta fucking rest at this thing. I don't know what I'm doing here. I don't know what to do. And there again, I took damage. Guy's a fucking asshole. Okay, this is what I was worried about. Because I've seen this. Seems like the safest way to dodge is off to this side. Gotcha. Fuck. Holy shit. Holy shit, that was tough. No, that's not something I can equip, that coiled sword, is it? Thrust enshrine bonfire to activate bonfire whip. Okay, no, it's not a weapon, it's just a freaking. Okay, wow, that was tough. That guy was a pain in the ass. Okay, well. Move on, I guess. That guy was a serious pain in the ass. And just think, I just started the game and I already had difficulties. Worse than what I've got. Where am I supposed to go now? All I can tell, this is going to be challenging. Homeward Bone, that sends me back to the last. No, what did that do? Yeah, return to last bonfire, that's right. See, with dual or with two handing your weapon, you can deal more damage, but without the shield, you don't block the damage from the attack, or you don't block nearly as much. So you take more damage if you get hit. I'm supposed to go. I'm assuming in there, but I don't know. Oh, that doesn't look good. Yeah, definitely don't want to go there. Okay, why are there blood stains everywhere here? That shield might be better than the one I've got. Yep. So I've got a better shield now, at least. I don't know where I should go. That's one of the things about the Dark Souls games. You're never really given a clear go this way first. It's kind of like explore on your own and discover it. Strength of flame, boosting HP until death. So is that like humanity, kind of? Okay, looks like I can either go up the stairs along the side or I can go in here. Oh, this looks... I know what this is. This is the, basically the Firelink Shrine. It's the home, sort of home base thing. From what I saw anyways, that's what it is. Right, things are starting to come back to me now about the games, like how you can't climb up on anything, you have to be able to jump to it from somewhere. Stuff like that. Do they just go off the side? What the hell? What are you? You're new. Is that another player? What in the fuck? What the fuck are you? What is that? What the hell was that? No, because I didn't get a message that I was invaded, so that couldn't have been another player, could it? That's just a fucking tough enemy, apparently. Bad idea, bad idea. I kinda wanna go back and get my souls, but I don't know if I'll probably get killed. Never mind. I'm not interested. I don't know what the fuck that thing is, but it's tougher than hell, apparently. Ah, it is the Firelink Shrine. The bonfire will deliver thee to Lothric. Okay. Jump down there and die. Yay! No. Oh wow, I'm over an hour. Well, 24 minutes. Over 24 minutes, probably closer to 30 or more, was spent fucking creating my character. You bastard, let me out of here. Do I have the thing for writing messages? Not yet. Unless... Ah! Okay. So it's like in the second one, you don't need an item for it, it seems. Praise the behind. Ah, this place again.
Ah, another one roused from the sleep of death.
Don't make me.
Well, you're not alone. We unkindled are worthless. Can't even die right. Gives me conniptions. And it have us seek the Lords of Cinder and return them to their molding thrones. But we're talking true legends, with the metal to link the fire. We're not fit to lick their boots.
Welcome to the bonfire, unkindled one. I am a firekeeper. I tend to the flame, and tend to thee. The lords have left their thrones,
there's a blacksmith back
and
there.
Must
awesome.
Be delivered to them. To this end, I am at thy side.
Level up. Well. Let's do that.
Then touch the darkness within me. Take nourishment from these sovereignless souls. Let these souls withdraw from manifest.
Okay.
Manifestations of disparity. Retreating to a darkness beyond. Let them assume. One.
I want to go and visit this guy back here real quick. Whoa, who are you?
A pleasure to make thine acquaintance, Ashen One.
I am creepy.
But a humble handmaid of the shrine.
You are fucking creepy.
Weapons, armor, trinkets, and spells. I've lots of little things to ease the burden of a weary traveler. And yes, I'm undead too, but not so charitable as to give my goods away. Ashen One, fetch souls and bring them to me. As is thy wont, no?
Thank you. take that. And that.
Ashen One, be sure to bring more souls.
Yeah, bring more souls, whatever. Wait, is that the same blacksmith from the first game?
Well, a newcomer, I see.
Looks like him.
I am Andre.
It is.
I serve at this shrine.
It's the same guy from the first game.
As humble smith, forging weapons. You're in search of the Lords of Cinder, I trust. A toilsome journey, I'd wager. You'll require good arms. Let me smith your weapons. I am a smith. Such is my purpose. Be careful. I don't want to see my work squandered.
Okay.
Ah, well met. How may I be?
Oh yeah, it was a thing, because I remember the repair powder. Where do I equip my spells? Okay, well, let's embed the coiled sword, and I think that'll give me the whole base thingy here, and I should be able to pick it up in the next one, then. Rest at bonfire. Ah, tomb spell, here we are. There we are. Now, I believe I should be able to end the game and pick it up from right here in the next one. So that's it for this one. Thank you everybody for level 13. Oh yeah, because you start out with levels, okay. Anyway, that's it for this one. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye. Find the right key on my keyboard.